I agree with let's mend it, not end it on the GSEs, because I think in the next couple years, we should look at the Community Reinvestment Act and see if the banks are saying Community Reinvestment Act investment equals FHA loans. And we should evaluate. In the past, they had special loan products that they created to help establish and foster home ownership with low and moderate income communities as well as communities of color. So we need to evaluate and balance. What are they doing in this next year? What are the big banks saying? Is CRA FHA?
We've actually testified before both the House and the Senate on the problems with the existing credit scoring programs, whether it's FICO or others, and what we call that black box. Also, that in the context of, quite frankly, the different cultures within our society. They're looking at things that aren't necessarily consistent with the ability to pay. We're looking for smooth transitions as people want to transition from renters to homeowners, and we want to make sure there's few obstacles to that process as possible. And certainly considering things like rent makes a huge difference. Listen, they were looking at crazy things like whether you were willing to actually finance yourself up to the wahoo, you know, with your credit cards. I come from a group of folks and whatnot, which I remember my mother kept her credit card in a sock in the bottom of her purse. And the only time it came out was in the case of an emergency. And when the bill came at the end of the month, she paid off the whole thing. Well, guess what? Credit scoring companies don't think that's a healthy attitude towards the economy and towards our credit. That makes no sense whatsoever to me. So you're absolutely right. We need additional systems to take very seriously people's ability to be able to pay and maintain and throughout. The whole issue here, one of the themes that's run through this whole conversation is sustainability, the ability to actually maintain those payments. What we saw happen, and it's really outrageous, that we're seeing the victims getting blamed the way they are because somebody came in and make a huge amount of money off the backs of people that could not sustain what they were trying. They were able to sustain their rents. So it just meant that we needed packages that actually protected them throughout that process. The government has to be involved as we move along those lines and find that kind of security as well.
So I would just add that I think moving forward, the issue of the impact of foreclosure on someone's credit score, which I think is bundled in with what you're asking about, is something that is, you know, we really have to find a way to confront.
And we have to be open to those innovative lending products. Nobody's asking anyone to be able to get away with anything. And that's really important for us to underscore with folks who represent the lending community or anybody else. We want a fair shake at this thing, knowing and recognizing that, you know, the world has changed. And we still have an obligation to get folks affordable housing, whether it's rental or whether it's home ownership. And we need to make sure that we're changing our criteria to adjust to what's reasonable and what is common sense. And it's something that over the course of time we've seen work effectively in different instances in our community. We can apply that today, but nobody's asking anybody to get away with anything. We want qualified borrowers who can make sure they can make the commitments they're being able to make. But if we don't adjust to based on the circumstances, everybody's going to lose in the end. It won't just be our community.
Well, just to drive home the point, we want to make sure we have a system that allows moderate and low-income people to enter the system and the access to capital and transition throughout. One of the things we see, unfortunately, with this second tier of subprime lending, and we're glad there's an option there. However, if you have to pay an early payment penalty to try to transition into the prime market, you've locked a number of people out as well. Again, it's a point of entry and a point of transition.
There's obviously a role for FHA, but we need to be thoughtful about it. But I will tell you, even the big four banks, maybe they're not saying this publicly, but privately, I'm hearing from them that saying, they absolutely need to preserve not just FHA, but a secondary market role. They don't want to see complete privatization occur. And a lot of them are saying that privately to us because they see that burden would shift a lot and dramatically to folks that wouldn't be able to have their needs met out there. So, yes, we can't rely entirely on the big four, but FHA has a certain role. But, you know, we just need to be thoughtful about what that can be. But I also know that privatization is not an answer here. And we're going to have to figure out something in between that's going to be the right balance. And I just think as long as we're aware of the key principles that we're trying to protect here when it comes to low-income and qualified borrowers, I think we should be able to figure out something.
I think with FHA, the issue is market saturation. And people and lenders, I mean, in the 70s, we looked at Chicago, Detroit, Cleveland, Toledo. I'm from Toledo. And FHA saturated the African-American and Latino neighborhoods, and we had no competition. And as a result, you had fraud in the appraisals, and people were buying homes in the summertime where their furnaces didn't work in the wintertime, and there was an abuse of the process. So you have to have market competition, and those other kinds of loan products must be available as well. For the legislative side, since I believe strongly that enforcement changes behavior, I would say that the federal regulators really need to step up and work with CFPB to engage in enforcement activities. The Justice Department has to start looking at the major big cases, get into the reverse redlining issues that are going on. And then HUD and the private market, the private fair housing groups have to enforce the Fair Housing Act. You need money to engage in enforcement. I'm not sure if, I would think anybody as a member of Congress wants our laws enforced. That's always been discussed. The laws are on the books for the Fair Housing Act, and if we enforce them across the board in a major way, I think that it will be very hard for the private market to neglect the communities that they historically have done.
And I would only first associate myself with those comments about making sure that the enforcement mechanism is in place, but we have to go back and revisit, quite frankly, the regulatory aspect of this as well, so we have something to actually clearly enforce, and revisit our principles. If the principle is we want to make sure that we have lines of credit that are sustainable and available to upstarts in the American society, that want very well the transition from rental to ownership in a sustainable way, that needs to be our policy objective. We want to make sure that everyone has the opportunity to buy in low. Quite frankly, we can probably take a poll, but my guess is that most people sitting at this table and most people sitting outside the tables there don't agree that down payment is going to make the difference about sustainability. The issues and challenges we had throughout this process of losing homes was the issues of sustainability. And quite frankly, moving into a private sector market in which quite the market works it out is outrageous. As a matter of fact, it is the living definition of insanity. We sat down with a number of our lawmakers, the Fed, the Comptroller of the Currency, members of Congress, to talk about challenges we were seeing. And it makes me nervous to say that we were so right. Mm-hmm. In 2007, when we actually asked for a moratorium on home foreclosures in 2007, mm-hmm. because we saw what was happening to the African-American Latino community as, quite frankly, a wave of foreclosure. We saw the steering into mm-hmm. products people could not sustain. We saw people being given these introductory exploding arm rate programs, doubling their monthly outpay at the end of a 6 to 8 year period. We knew it was a recipe for a disaster, and we tried to stop them then. What we're saying now is that people should have an opportunity, a real American opportunity, to enter the process of home ownership. That needs to be our principle. It should be one that is sustainable. And part of that process means we're going to have a very rigorous enforcement of these protectionary laws that we've worked so hard to put in place if we're going to be successful throughout America. So we'll look forward to sitting down and working out those details. You all are our friends, by the way. And we'll make sure we get everything we want in what you're going to do for us on Capitol Hill.
Just one last note, I guess. You know, the white paper did focus a lot, I think, more details on the homeownership side than on the renter side. So I certainly think that there needs to be more specifics there, because I think that it didn't go into a lot of specifics about what alternative options that would be sort of in the middle from, you know, very affordable, highly subsidized rental, you know, to homeownership. There's a lot in between there that needs to get figured out. So I think that we haven't spent enough time in that arena to figure out more of, like, what are some of the shared shared equity options? What are some of the co-op models? What are some of the rent-to-own? I mean, revisiting some things and kind of like refreshing some of those ideas. I certainly think that, you know, for those, for many people, stable, regular rental rent payments are going to be the pathway to establish credit to homeownership. And then for those that for whom homeownership is not an option, rental needs to be there. That's quality. So I think that, you know, there's more discussion that's needed on the renter side in terms of the white paper, and I'll just end with that.